Dear Occupy Justice, dear Auturi, and all of you who have joined them today, it is a great honor for me to address you. I would sincerely wish to be present personally. I truly admire the courage and perseverance you show, standing up for your country, for your compatriots, and for the democratic values you hold dear. Malta grew on me from the first day of my stay. I was absolutely fascinated by the elegant Valletta, vibrant Lima, mysterious Medina, and the natural beauty of Ain Tufiha. But most of all, I enjoyed the company of Maltese people, smiling, friendly, kind, always ready to help. I believe all Maltese to be that, even those who are now supporting the wrong. I understand those supporting the wrong. They might simply desire to belong somewhere, to be a part of a powerful group. But I believe by your example you can prove to them that the true value is not in belonging to a party, but to a credible nation, and that one should not merely be proud of a monetary wealth, but of the holistic aspect of living in a community. I have spoken of what I knew about what was happening at Pilatus Bank because someone had to stop it. It is not just in Malta that richer people find access to corrupt who help them have their way. But in Malta, I certainly found people willing to fight for the truth and justice, no matter how powerful the adversary is. That's what I found in Daphne Caruana Galizia, a brave woman unearthing the truth and seeking justice. That's what I find here with me today, brave people who expect no reward and no profit from what they are working for, except the reward of knowing that you live in a country you love and you live for your children a future better than your past. I call upon people whose courage still fails them. They know the truth, but they are afraid to say it. None of them want to have their words spoken from a stage like this. None of them have ever sought fame or notoriety. None of them would spend time as I had in jail waiting for the basic right to enjoy their children in peace to be considered by a judge, then they've done nothing wrong. I took my own risks, then I walked in an open court to testify to what I knew. I understand not everyone can do that, but everyone can do what I started out with, speak to a trustworthy journalist who will protect you from the abuse of those who would rather keep you silent. Like Daphne Caruana Galizia, there are good and honest journalists in Malta, and there are good and honest journalists in the Daphne Project. I've come to know some of them. They have helped me fight the battle for truth. There can be no justice without truth, and there can be no truth without whistleblowers and journalists working together to bring it out. I call on people with information to work with journalists. Truth shall prevail. I have a hope and I have faith.